What up, YouTube? It's really early. I get up early. Usually I'm at the gym. It's about 4:30 a.m. my time, which is probably why I look like I just woke up. If it looks that way, it's because I did. Now, I did some Stan Walker. You guys got me on a little rabbit hole, and somebody sent me a really nice comment yesterday and kind of lined out or outlined a bunch of other stuff. Can't even talk right now. To check out, so I'll get into some Kiwi stuff. By the way, I have been to New Zealand before. When I was like 17, 18, I it's beautiful. I'd love to be able to move there, but y'all have some rules that you just don't want people, expats and from the States to be in your country there, which I get. It's worth protecting. But definitely one of the most beautiful places I've ever seen in my life. Very green. I spent some time in Australia, so then after that, when I went to New Zealand, it was very different. Australia, we stayed like in the south, obviously, like Sydney, Melbourne, Perth. I stayed in Canberra with a family. Anyways, that's neither here nor there. You guys wanted me to check out Amazing Grace. Now, taking some music classes, Amazing Grace, obviously a very well-known song. So we all know the words. The history behind it's a little rough for me. Those are college years that I learned that. There's a dog behind me. Hey, pup. It was John Newton, right? Who the original lyrics were by, and then it was done by, like, I think our version that we know the best is probably what Aretha, Ray Charles did it, Johnny Cash, Elvis, shoot, I think Barack Obama sang it at a tribute. So the song itself has a lot of religious purposes. From what I remember, John Newton was in slave trade. Now, this is late 1700s. And his boat went, or the ship he was on went awry, like in somewhere in Ireland. And I don't know like the exact details. He sort of like apparently he found God, he became like ordained, and so it has a lot of meaning to people, both as for religious purposes, because it's been used a lot as like a religious or Christian, usually hymn. And for secular purposes as well, it could be like the death of a loved one, or and I think it's probably been played more than any song ever, or at least here in the States, just because of the amount of people that have sort of covered that. And it's one of those songs that has meaning to a lot of people. So I may or may not be stopping a lot and just saving my comments to the end, because everybody loves this song. He did. I saw he did Hallelujah too. One of my favorites. I'd love to hear him sing that. So I'm excited about that. Sometime when it's not 4 in the morning. But either way, let's jump in and see what Stan's got on some Amazing Grace. I'm sure that it's got some meaning to him as well. After reading some more about him, the struggles and things that he's gone through. A lot of these songs you can kind of pick and choose the way that you want to sort of relate to them. Did I forget about Willie Nelson, my boy? I think he sung it too. Yeah. Anyways, let's jump right in. Hold on, I'm getting no volume here.
How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Somebody, if you could, please translate that for me.
Was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Yeah, if you know the story, the lyrics actually make a lot of sense. And that's why you can apply it in many different ways. I once was lost, but now I'm found. So I was not on the correct path. So obviously with the original, lyrics and who wrote them, Mr. Newton, talking about, having to have to experience something like what he did, and coming up with such a beautiful song.
Blind, but now I see.
You see his intro right there, like they just they're singing backup, so they're keeping it at a certain place, and he cuts right in. I don't know if you notice, like you look, you know, he's like, where is that coming from?
How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but
putting their own spin on the instrumentals there. I haven't heard it done like that, really. Okay, you could definitely see how he interprets the song himself through this. That's really cool. That's a powerful thing to be able to do. You bring in the piano there, and it turns into this sort of uplifting, you know, very sort of hopeful feel, the undertones to what he just did there. There's a lot of ways to take this song and these lyrics. Now we're jamming. I love it. So we sort of it starts off kind of slower, kind of somber, and then like I said, just uplifting, and now we're just now we're jamming, we're smiling. I like the thumbs up. You did good, pal. No, I didn't. I tried not to stop that too much. It's just that song is just a staple. I'll definitely throw that in a rotation somewhere, and that was great. I think that's probably my favorite that I've seen of him yet. Albeit, I haven't seen much of him, but I am following your guys' recommendations. Yeah, so I'll post this real quick. I'm gonna do some. I'm gonna get sort of off this path for a second. I've got a couple other sort of interesting recommendations. You'll see if you follow my channel, which you should do, because you should always like, comment, hit your mic, subscribe. It's not that hard. I'm up here at 4 a.m. Just busting my ass. No, I'm just kidding. I don't sleep very well, but. Let's see if I can get that to my slogan for the day that y'all should follow is be a fucking lion, go kill some shit, work hard, repeat. Take that with you today. Do exactly that. Thanks for the rec, of course. I'll be listening to more of him, and yeah, y'all have a wonderful Thursday if it is Thursday where you're from. All right, yeah. We'll talk to you soon. See ya. I'm out.